Hi, I'm Chris here. Welcome to my channel. If this is the first time you're watching my video, please make sure you read on the description and the title below for the current software version that I'm using right now. My goal with this channel is to help you to become a better modeler. So please take a moment and let me know in the comment how am I doing. Remember to leave a thumbs up so it can help the YouTube to share this video with a wider audience. And if you aren't subscribed, please do so and click on the bell for future content. Today in this video, I will teach you some tricks and tips on how to import drawing in TASC-III, including the format of CAD, PDF, scan PDF, and JPEG. Let's move on. Once you open up your TASC-III, it will be at this page. Okay, you have to click on the new project and then press OK. So after that, it will bring you to the modeling phase, which is this phase. Yeah, so you're quite confused, and for if you're first time using this software, you were quite confused. There are a lot of function and ribbon over here and you will get overwhelmed, but do not worry, I will guide you step by step on how to import the drawing. Firstly, go to the tab here, identify. As you can see here, there's a tab color in blue. Actually, it's not color in blue, it's highlighted in blue. If you move on the drawing tab, the ribbon will be different. You see? Click on the identify and then look on this drawing manager and the layer manager. Usually by default, this drawing manager and layer manager, it will appear automatically, but sometimes it won't appear, or sometimes you may be accidentally close this thing. So what should you do is that you click on this drawing manager. My click definition of click is that I press on the mouse, left click. Okay, it will appear, and left click again, it will hide. Same goes to drawing manager. Okay, so you look at this small icon over here. There's a paper like thing and a orange color plus over here. This is called the add drawing. So you can press on this one, short key, or you can move over here to press on the add drawing. Either way will do. Okay, so for the drawing location, either you have two methods. You can go to search on this drawing yourself, or you can use another method is that get your drawing folder ready, right? Click onto this tab here and you will see the highlighted area of the folder location, either in highlighted in blue. Control C to copy or right click to copy and then move on to this location. Let's say if there's a location over here, you can just delete it by pressing backspace or backspace and then Control V to paste or right click to paste. There's a short key for Control V. Yeah. And press enter, it will bring you to the drawing file here. Okay, press on this layout, the key plane here, and then click on open. For the drawing type over here, you can just ignore this thing. It's by default for this latest version. It by default, I think most of the drawing it will able to import. Do not need to select manually on this one. Okay, click on OK, open. Then it will appear the drawing over here. So there will be the layout, the key plan at the middle of the black screen, and then there will be a small part like model layout and layout one over here. Alright, so for myself, I personally like to open up the drawing, which is I open up the folder and open up the drawing. So, and I put it on my left screen. By the way, I have both screen, to both monitor. So, I think this is the best productive tools for me is that I can view it side by side, which is much more easier for my modeling process and everything. Yeah, let's say I can view this one on layout and I can also view it the section below like this. Yeah, the section for this house below. So from here I do not need to like scroll my mouse up and down for the view. Yeah, right. Okay, so for this one, I think this one is for my opinion, this is very good for when you're doing a more complex job. For small job it should be okay, you can use either single tab should be fine. Okay, but single tab means that you can open up and close the tab like this. because in much more complicated project, I may be open up a lot of drawings, let's say around 20 drawings. Sometimes you refer to the section and specification, architect drawing, structure drawing, floor above and floor below, and something so on, right? Okay, so for this one, I need to explain on what is this thing model and layout 2 is. This thing is actually is a refer to the drawing. It's called the layout 2 and layout 1. Usually in architect draftman and the structural draftman, they will get this thing ready for printing. So the when they model up everything ready, they will cut this one, and it's not cut, it's move this one to the layout 2 and rescale this thing according to the A3 and A1 size. So if you search for this layout 2 and layout 1, the scale might not be correct, right? Okay. So from here, usually if you do not need this layout 1, layout 2, you can just delete it, or maybe you can leave it there. But I personally like to delete this thing because I find it do not useful, and it's quite make it a lot quite messy, right? Okay. So move on to this one. Yeah, how do you check this thing is actually right according to skill? You can use this method called measure distance. Right click on the mouse. Okay, you will see this measure distance and click left click on it, and you'll see this thing change. It will tell the next step what should you going to do. Specify the first point. For the first point, meaning is that when you move your mouse cursor close enough to the cat line here, usually in the end or in the middle of the line intersect point, it will become, you'll see a yellow cross circle and both of them. It means that you can press any of them. You can just click on the intersect point to make it more accurate. Yeah. Left click once and then move on. Yeah, by moving this thing is that you need to press on the zoom key. Yeah, there's a scroll, zoom in, zoom out, or you can hold it so you can move this drawing. Okay, move to the end of this intersection point here, and you will see the 6706. From here, I do not need to press, I just move it and gently move it to this intersect point. You will see actually it's the same scale, 6706. Right, for this second function, it means that constantly is that you click on this one, the first point, and you click on the next point, it will sum up the whole point. The 6706 times 2 become 13,000. Yeah, this one, right? Okay, so once you satisfy with this thing, right click to cancel, and it will appear over here, right? Okay, so let's move on. To cancel this thing, you can press escape, then this thing will be cancelled, right? So to move on, this thing is that the scale is correct, then you should be able to speed your drawing by using the speed function. Let's say I want to speed on the first tab here. I need to click on this speed function over here, speed drawing, or you can click on this speed drawing over here. Hold, press and hold on your left key until you reach the drawing that you want to split, just like this one. Let's say I do not need this area, I press escape and I do it split drawing again like this. So right click to confirm, refer to a bar below, and then you appear this input name. Just click in the name on the CAD drawing, or you can key in by yourself, GF floor. Okay, depend on you what you want to key in the name. It will appear GF floor over here. So for this one, to don't want to make it too confused, I will delete this drawing, pressing this delete drawing key over here. Right? Okay. So from here, you can just move into ground floor. By the way, once you successfully split the drawing, it will appear this red circle box here. It's mean that this drawing has been successfully split. Move to this ground floor and you will see your drawing has been split, successfully split over here. You see, look around, you do not have the a bigger circle and also the project title, which is mainly on the project alone. Okay, so right now you've successfully split on the CAD drawing. Now we have to move on to the PDF. For the PDF drawing, use back the same method at drawing using this icon. Click on this PDF. I did not touch anything below here and press open. Yeah, there will be the drawing appear below here. Yeah, okay, so this is actually the same ground floor plan, but I do it in the PDF form, so I can like demonstrate on how do I import this thing in the Cubic software. So from here, once I import this PDF, for PDF is that you need to know this drawing is not to scale, mostly it's not to scale. So you have to scale it yourself by press the scale drawing, click on the area, hold it until you see the bigger circle over here, and release your left click and right click to confirm. Then it will ask you to specify the endpoint of the baseline, means the first point. Zoom in, make sure you do not press on this random point. Unclick this random point so you do not press around any other point beside this intersection point, because you want to scale correctly. Okay, spot on to this yellow cross. Okay, once you press on the left click, it will appear something like this. It's a bigger cross. Move on to the second point, which is over here. Okay, and remember for this figure 6706, because you need to key in this thing later. Move to here, press OK, and press again, left click, then you will appear this actual length. Just key in as according to the distance, and press OK. Okay, so you can either zoom out, which is it will take quite some time, or you can double click on the zoom, the scroll. It will immediately bring up to the interface here. Yeah. Okay. So from here, you can just skew it again. For my practice, I usually skew PDF or JPEG, skew it twice, because even how many times you skew, it will actually not to skew. Okay, I do it again. Click on the left click, search for the yellow cross, click on the left click over here, okay, and search on the next point. By moving this thing is a hold on to the scroll and click on the left click over here, okay, the next intersect point, you see the figure will not be the same. 705, so you had to adjust it to yourself. Press OK. Yeah, on the second time of scaling, it will be much more accurate. Okay, so this is where you do on the import and also do on the PDF. So another part is the split drawing. It will be the same as this now. Press on the split, hold it on the area that you want to split and release it, and then right click to confirm, click on the layer, change the name, and press OK. Yeah, it will appear over here. Okay, PDF done. Right now we move to scan PDF. Okay, for scan PDF, it will be look like this one. It's actually scan. You see, if you zoom into this PDF, it actually scan is, you see, you can't zoom in and found there's a line anywhere over here. So scan copy is usually like similar to image. So for that one, you can import using the same method again. Click on the add drawing, click on the scan, and open it. Okay, once it appear, double click on it. If right now you will see this drawing over here. Right now you can't use this. You see, when it's a picture or scan copy, you can't use the scale function and the split function. Remember that it's only for the software. Is that when it able to detect the layer, the CAD layer line, this function will appear. When it cannot detect, it won't appear. So what should we do to scale this thing? You need to move on to this import picture. Picture over here, not the drawing picture. Search for scale picture. Okay, once you successfully click on it, left click, okay, and then select the picture and right click to cancel. Select the picture by select on the left click. And once you select the left click, it will appear the icon is different. You see the now right now there's a cross in the square, right? So we have to zoom in to the intersect point here. From here, you need to click on this random point because you can't point anything now. Sometimes you'll be able to point, but sometimes it won't. Okay, move on to the second point. Okay, so from here, you can just key in the actual scale and press OK. Okay, press on double click on the scroll, it will bring you out here. So usually for image, I will prefer that you need to scale twice because of the accuracy is not that accurate most of the time. So scale again. For this time, it's quite accurate. Okay. So even how accurate is it, sometimes scan copy, it may not be because it's a picture format and it's scanned. Sometimes it will appear like it cannot be the side over here and side over here is not to scale. So it's quite inconvenient if you get the drawing in scan copy. Okay. Right now, I already demonstrated that you can scan copy, PDF, and CAD drawing. Okay, but for one more thing is that scan copy, you cannot split. Yeah, in this version software, scan copy, you cannot split the drawing. You can only import the drawing. That's all. PDF can, and CAD you can split, but scan copy can't. And right now, I want to import for the image. We have an image over here. This thing is actually an image. You see JPEG. Double click on it, this thing, it will appear a JPEG, right? Okay, for this drawing format, it will actually same as this scan PDF. You just need to move on to import this drawing. You are unable to import it from through here. You see, it will not appear over here. It's supposed to be there's one drawing over here in this folder named JPEG, but it did not appear anything over here. Okay, to do this, you need to go to this features over here, click on the import picture, and then you will see, yeah, it will appear over here. You see, click on this one and press open. Okay, so the drawing will be automatically imported over here. This is actually the drawing, by the way. So scale the drawing. Sorry, it is located. Sorry, I'm sorry. Scale the drawing. Okay, you see. 676, yeah. So I demonstrated the few methods of how to import the drawings. Okay, stay tuned for the next video. I will teach you how to do on the axis line. Okay, thank you.